We are here in Ackerson Meadow in Yosemite National Park. Ackerson was donated to Yosemite in 2016. It was the largest land contribution to the park in 70 years. Ackerson Meadow is a part of a 190-acre meadow complex. About 100 of those acres have been degraded or lost due to a large erosion channel, and there are still 90 acres intact. The goal of this project is to restore those 100 acres of lost wetland and protect the 90 acres that remain. This is one of the largest mid-elevation meadow complexes in the Sierra, and this is the largest restoration project that's been attempted in Yosemite National Park. Ackerson Meadow is home to multiple endangered species. We have the willow flycatcher. They're not found anywhere else in Yosemite National Park. Ackerson Meadow provides key habitat for great gray owls, for fisher, as well as northwestern pond turtles.
California is a biodiversity hotspot, and when you consider all of the species that live in the Sierra Nevada, and there are many, most of them have a portion of their life cycle depends on meadows or riparian habitat. The amount of biodiversity, including a number of threatened and endangered species that call Ackerson home, is probably the most compelling argument for why is Ackerson important, and that's in this degraded condition.
Meadows provide numerous functions and values for wildlife, for humans, for plants. They are their own ecosystem. Meadows are wetlands. They provide oases of moisture in the dry Mediterranean climate of California. So they are highly productive for insects, they're highly productive for plants, they store carbon, they help attenuate floods.
Meadows, when they are functional, support water supply and water quality. Meadows act like a sponge. And when there's a lot of snow melt and spring runoff across these meadows, they sort of soak it up and they hold it as shallow groundwater.
Ackerson Meadow is somewhat unique in the fact that it's a low elevation, large meadow that has now been brought into public ownership. Most meadows of this elevation and size are privately owned and privately held because we're at about 4,600 feet elevation, which is right at the lower limit of snow line. So this is a great place to live year round. And it was a homestead and a ranch, a cattle ranch, for the last 150 years. And we're here because one of the most common impacts to meadows in the Sierra is erosion, large scale erosion.
It's not that anybody was trying to hurt the meadows, but decades of logging, road building, ditching, grazing, basically overutilization that caused erosion in Ackerson Meadow.
Sierra Nevada meadows are wetlands, and they receive a lot of water flow during spring runoff, when snow melts, and during thunderstorm activity. And the plants of these meadows are really what hold the soil in place. And so when cattle graze or sheep graze the plants and trample soil, it exposes that soil to erosion. That soil can start to move downstream and cause gullying. Once a gully starts forming, it just keeps getting bigger and worse. A gully that's draining water and concentrating flow lowers water table within the entire meadow. And that converts a meadow from a wetland into a dry meadow, changing the plant community entirely, changing the animals that use the meadow, altering the entire meadow ecosystem into something else.
And now what we have in Ackerson is a 3 mile long erosion gully that's 14 feet deep and 100 feet wide. That's actively draining the meadow of its water and lowering the water table.
The most direct way of restoring a meadow to its wetland function is to eliminate that erosion gully. And to do that, you simply fill in that erosion gully with earth, with soil. And that involves a lot of excavators, dump trucks, and a lot of heavy equipment.
It's really alarming to see heavy equipment in a meadow, but we took every precaution we could to minimize the amount of impacts we had with this equipment. We had a limited operating period, which means we only worked during months that songbirds were no longer in the meadow and when other important species were no longer nesting nearby.
The material we used to fill in the gully was excavated from nearby hillsides that were impacted by fires, by logging, by roads. And those areas are nearby to Ackerson Meadow, so the trucking distance was short. Before we dug into those hillsides, we cut down what trees were there. Again, mostly burned trees. Those were chipped and incorporated in with the fill to provide organic matter content for the fill that goes in the gully. We also have to get all of the shrubs out. So willows were harvested, salvaged, set aside, and then replanted. Once we filled the gully in, they were planted back on the wetland surface and they'll be much happier with their feet in the water. At the bottom of the gully was a narrow ribbon of wetland right against the creek margin, and all of that sod was also salvaged, set aside, and replaced on the top. Ackerson Meadow is a really valuable wildlife area, and it supports a large population of the northwestern pond turtle.
Northwestern pond turtle is a species of special concern in California. They're endangered in Washington, and they're being considered for listing under the Endangered Species Act right now. These turtles are highly cryptic. They're hard to see. They're very wary of people. So we are monitoring the turtle populations using trapping, and we're also outfitting many of those animals with radio telemetry equipment so that we can follow them and during the restoration be able to get them out of harm's way and relocate them.
We also had trained turtle detection dogs that could find turtles based on scent. So before equipment would enter an area, we would have that area cleared by detection dogs. And whenever that area was densely vegetated, we would also have people come in and clear by hand. In phase one, we brought in 60,000 cubic yards of fill to fill the gully to raise the meadow to a uniform surface to allow the water table to raise and to allow water to spread out from meadow edge to meadow edge.
We can't just fill in the gully and walk away. We need to protect that surface with erosion blanket and then plant hundreds of thousands of plants that we have grown from seed collected here in Ackerson Meadow.
Today we're out here collecting seeds in Ackerson Meadow. You get to channel your inner hunter-gatherer instincts and spend your days in a beautiful place. Hopefully gonna be sowing over 1,000 pounds of seed. So out here almost every day this fall, gathering as much as we can for the restoration of Ackerson.
During the earthwork, we had to dewater the meadow, take all the water out of the gully and send it down in a pipe to the end of the project. And as soon as all of the earthwork was done, we turned the pumps off and pulled the pipeline. And that water was then let to flow onto our work, and it slowly saturated the fill that we had placed, the erosion blanket, and just crept forward, slowly, slowly bringing wetland conditions back to a meadow that's been dry for the last 150 years. It was really gratifying to see the re-wetting of the meadow and to know that all of that meadow that gets re-wetted will re-sprout wetland plants. And next spring, from forest edge to forest edge, this meadow will be flourishing as a wetland again for the first time in a century and a half.
We try to focus on getting these natural processes going again, and that will allow these systems to sustain themselves long after we're gone. We've set the lower portion of this meadow kind of on that correct trajectory. We've just finished the first year of work. Next year, we'll do the upstream half.
The park's mission is to preserve and protect these lands for future generations, and Yosemite is doing a lot of really good restoration work, and helping this land heal on an ecosystem level. Ackerson has been a highly interdisciplinary project, and I think that level of collaboration really shines and shows that if we come together, that we can accomplish some pretty big things.
It takes a whole team to pull something like this off. We have folks from Yosemite National Park and Stanislaus National Forest. We have support from Yosemite Conservancy and from American Rivers.
And having the opportunity to just have a role in that is amazing. It's very motivating, especially when you're out here every day in the sun. It's like, we're doing this to restore a huge meadow. It's important. It means something.
In 5 years, it'll be an intact wetland. It'll be full of songbirds and wildflowers and water flowing across the surface. It's going to be quite a beautiful sight to see.